Hello, everyone. I actually haven't tested any of my sound or anything, so I do hope you can hear me. I'll just check to see if my microphone is working. It seems to be working. I'm hoping you'll be able to hear the music as well. It's a bit of alternative tonight because tonight David is working. He has got a gig comedian. He's being a comedian. And I was going to edit last year's Christmas show together, but then I thought, oh, do you know what? It's easier just for me to sit here for an hour and play you my favourite Christmas songs. So I'm going to play you my favourite Christmas songs. If anybody is watching and you have a favourite Christmas song, can you then like just type it in the comments and tell me that you have a favourite Christmas song? Because if you tell me you have a favourite Christmas song, then I, Steve Henn, will be able to play it. Okay? So, what I want you to do is think of your favourite song. Let me know. Come along. Join in. Join in. Tonight is a Christmas join-in song. We're going to play music. Christmas songs. These are the songs that are, I feel, alternative. They are alternative Christmas songs. There is one classic, I think, I've bunged in there. But most of them, I'm thinking you may not have heard of them. You may have heard of the artists, but you may, and you may have heard of the songs. There are a few classic covers. There's nothing wrong with a classic cover, I feel. So, welcome to Steve Henn's Alternative Christmas Songs. On the screen, there should be a little word that says songs. Please feel free to tell me your favourite Christmas song. And maybe we can have some fun because it is now the countdown to Christmas. We have what? It's now Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Christmas Eve. Saturday is Christmas Day, which normally would be more exciting than it is. But fuck it, it's a pandemic and we're going to squeeze it by its neck. We're just going to enjoy ourselves. So if you know any Christmas songs that you like, any Christmas songs, do leave a comment because it's only me today. So I need as much help as possible. Please leave a comment and tell me your favourite Christmas song. I'm going to play you 10 different songs. You might like them. You might not. If you like them, let me know. Please let me know. Right. What are you saying? Stop talking, Steve. You've been talking for 2 minutes, 30 seconds. Nobody knows what's going on. Of course they don't. Okay. First Christmas song. I love this band. Twisted Sister. Dee Snider is a madman. So let's just play the song. It's Oh Come All You Faithful, but in a very heavy metal way.
Sing, rise of angels, sing.
Oh, come all ye faithful, Twisted fucking Sister. Now, many of you may not even know Twisted Sister, but that Twisted Sister, Twisted Christmas, has got some great songs on it. If you like your music, then do have a listen to a Christmas, especially during this festive period. Now, I've decided I'm going to tell you a joke after every song. And the only joke that came to my mind there was, I bought my wife some perfume for Christmas. She said, what is it? I said, it's called Come to Me. She says, it doesn't smell like Come to Me. So, the next song, I think we're going to go, Remember a Little Girl from the X Factor. Who remembers Janet Devlin? Elton John's cover of your song. Honestly, she's still doing a lot of stuff on what's it called? Patreon? Yeah. So you know, she does some really good stuff. And this is one of her Christmas songs that she released, I think a few years ago. There you go. I think a few years ago. Janet Devlin released this Happy Holidays. It's a jolly, jolly, jolly song. If you're watching now live and not listening to this on Spotify, please let me know what your favourite Christmas song is. And I will give you a shout out. Today is Christmas shout out time. So do leave a comment. Tell me what your favourite Christmas song. Do you know what your Christmas favourite song is? I don't either. Right, I don't know if my fire is too loud. Tell me if my fire is too loud because I can turn it down. Unlike working for Asda. Right, so let's have a listen to Janet Devlin's Happy Holidays.
Everybody's out playing in the snow, but I'm sat here beside the fire, 'cause you know don't like the cold. And everyone's out dancing in the street, singing songs and carols while the children are asleep. But that's just not for me. And just 'cause you're a little more festive than me doesn't mean I don't enjoy a good holiday. So no, I want you to know, yourself a merry, happy, jolly, festive Christmas time. You do yours the way you do, and I'll be fine the way I do mine. Have yourself a merry, happy, jolly, festive Christmas time. I'll be drinking whiskey, no wine. So happy holidays, happy holidays. We're in festive hats of gold. Don't forget these days, we're always told. And just 'cause you're a little more festive than us doesn't mean we won't enjoy our time this Christmas. So no, we want you to know. Have yourself a merry, happy, jolly, festive Christmas time. The way you do, and I'll be fine the way I do mine. And have yourself a merry, happy, jolly, festive Christmas time. I'll be drinking whiskey, no wine. So happy holidays, happy holidays, happy holidays, happy holidays.
S for Steve. Happy holidays, Janet Devlin. Seriously, that's a good contender for a Christmas song. It's got everything you need. It's got whiskey, it's got wine, it's got a jolly beat to it. Do check out Janet Devlin's stuff. She's got a great voice. And she was in the X Factor. You can't argue with the X Factor. Right, holiday joke. I don't know. I opened the curtains this morning. I said, oh, looks like reindeer. Which is weird considering I live on my own. So, yeah, that's Janet Devlin from The X Factor. My next Christmas song is, I believe, a contender for that Mariah Carey one that everyone bangs on about. Oh, Mariah Carey, that's a fucking great song, that is. It's not, in my opinion. Why couldn't it be Christmas every day? Obviously, I've put some brackets there somewhere. Some of these things where they shouldn't have been. Bianca Ryan was the first person in 2006 to fly to the moon. Nope. She was actually the first winner of America's Got Talent in 2006. She was 11 years of age. She sang, I think it was a Whitney song, that was incredible. But why couldn't it be Christmas every day? Honestly. Better than Mariah Carey. Don't take my word for it. Let's have a listen to Bianca Ryan's Why Couldn't It Be Christmas Every Day?
Calendar rearranging. Let every
Why couldn't it be Christmas every day? Asked Bianca Ryan in 2006. Can I say 2006? 2006 is fine, isn't it? 2006, America's Got Talent, first winner, Bianca Ryan. Oh, the song that she sang, which wasn't a Whitney Houston, it was from the Dreamgirls, and I'm not telling you. No, I will. That's the song, and I'm not telling you. Yeah. She's 27 now, I would imagine. That makes, not that I imagine, that sounds weird. No, I'm assuming in 2006, and she was 11, then she should be about 27 now, I think. So, she's still doing, I think she took some time off, but she's come back with a more mature voice. But Bianca Ryan, check out, and I'm not telling you, because that is very, 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 very good. Right, I hope you're looking forward to Christmas. I know it's a shitter. It's a shitter, and there's not a lot we can do about it. And I do think it's going to get worse. But, as with everything, it will eventually be better. So, you know, hold on to the fact that Boris Johnson can't live forever, so there will be another Prime Minister. Hold on to the fact that we will get some way through this. Please, 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 if you've not been vaccinated yet and you're worried and you're not sure why you should, just get vaccinated. I mean, I'm going for my booster tomorrow. On Monday, I'm having my booster so I can sit up higher in the back seat of the car. No, seriously, get yourself vaccinated if you haven't. Get yourself boosted. You've got nothing to lose but fear itself. Do it. If you really have a strong objection, fine. But if the reason that you object to getting the booster is because Auntie Mavis on Facebook said her ball sack was going to swell, then don't fucking bother. Right. Who's... Do you know... When I was growing up in the 70s, there was a, like, now can it be Christmas, whatever it was. And they had the same, like, 12 songs on, and that every store now still plays them. It's the same 12 songs. Don't worry, you Whamageddon fans. No Wham in this show. I'm not even going to mention the song. But last Christmas, I lasted till the 24th of fucking December. This Christmas, I was out on the 1st of fucking December, thanks to James fucking O'Brien. Right, don't want to swear tonight. So, yes, what was I going to say? Yeah, so we listened to this album, Now Christmas, whatever it was called, and, like, same Christmas songs year after year after year after year. And then nobody does a really good Christmas album until about 4-5 years ago. Sia! Don't want to be ya. Sia! Candy Cane Lane. I played last Christmas. Oh, there you see. I've done another Whamageddon thing. Puppies Are Forever, which I personally think is my favourite song on the album. But this is, if you want a Christmas album that you can play for like 4 days over Christmas, Sia's Candy Cane Lane, no, Sia's Christmas album, Every Day is Christmas, is either worth streaming or buying. And Sia is tremendous.
Down Candy Cane Lane with me. It's so magical and it's down there in you.
There you go. Sears Candy Cane Lane, which I think was 2017. The album came out. Every Day is Christmas. And honestly, for one of the new Christmas albums, it's well worth it. I'm playing another good Christmas album track in a couple of songs. From another American lady or American woman. Male construct, be careful. So, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Steve Henn, when are you going to play one of the classic songs of Christmas? One of the classic songs of Christmas. Now, I do believe this is a classic song of Christmas, although you may not believe it from the title. The title is 2,000 Miles, The Pretenders. I went to see Tim Vine before lockdown. I think that was the last comedy gig I saw before lockdown, unless it was one of mine. And to be honest, they're not funny. So, and Tim Vine said that there should only be one tribute act, and that should be The Pretenders. Which I think is a very funny joke. Right, so this is a classic Christmas song, 2,000 Miles by The Pretenders.
It must be Christmas time.
There you go. The Pretenders, a classic Christmas song from The Pretenders. 2,000 Miles. That's the only classic one. I am actually playing my favourite ever Christmas song. It's got everything. It's got everything in it, I think, that a Christmas song needs. It's got a nice little jingly, jingly, tingly bit in it. It's got sentimental. It's got the mention of the word Jesus. I mean, you know, the word Christmas obviously suggests the word Christ's mass. But like all Christian holidays and ceremonies, it was nicked from others. So like, if you believe in any religion, then that's fine. I'm not going to take that away from you. But, you know, Christmas is not about the birth and the death of some fictitious being. I'm sorry. If you believe in Jesus, that's fine. That's fine. But there's three things I never believed in, right? Ghosts, God, and animal porn. Unfortunately, I do believe in one of those now. It's not ghosts, but it took me 27 years though. But I still, the other two, I've got no proof of. I've got no proof of Jesus or ghosts. So like, they may exist, they may not, but it seems to me that religion was created to keep people in a place. But, you know, anyway, what was I going to say? Christmas, yeah. Christmas has got nothing to do with Christ. Of course it has, for a lot of people. But I'm saying Christmas is about the chocolate. And, of course, the man in the red coat with the white beard. Mr. Parcel Force Man. Or, as Susie McNeil would say, Santa. I'm waiting for you.
Counting down the days till I see your fuzzy face and rosy cheeks so cute. I keep my chimney clean, holding on to the dream. You miss me too.
I'm waiting for you, Susie McNeil. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, who the M&M is Susie McNeil? Well, can you remember the guy that was found swinging on the back of the hotel bedroom door after he had sex with Kylie Minogue? Not after. Not straight after. What was his name? Peter Hutchinson. Not Peter Hutchinson. Hey, the lead singer from NXS, right? No longer with us. They did a competition to find a new replacement for the singer of NXS. And Susie McNeil got through to the finals. And she should have won it. But I think the only reason she didn't win it in an all-male band was the fact that she was a better singer than everybody else. Hey ho, it's going to get better, isn't it? It's going to get better for the... But no, I do think it was because she was a woman. But like, she's got a great voice. And I think she stopped, that was recorded in 2012. And I don't think she's done much since then. But honestly, if you like NXS, have a look at Rockstars NXS. Because it's quite a fun show to watch. But that's a great song. Right, we're going over to the hits now. We've got the hits. It reached 27 in the UK charts. In, I think, 1981. I could be wrong. 1991. Check your notes, Steve Henn. Check yourself. And I say that goes out to all you men out there. Check yourself before Christmas. All right? I've got myself to be checked. It would be COVID tests. Check yourself and get boosted. This is the winter song, Angel. Angel, a great band that people should have known more about. This starts off a bit prissy, but then it kicks in. It kicks in like a really good song should.
Days on.
Hey, do you know, I do love Angel. Nigel Cutler, if you're listening, that song's for you. Merry Christmas to you and your family. I could do shout outs for the last 20 minutes of the show. Stevie Kewin, bad day we had Saturday down the wherever it was in Blackburn. But yeah, I'm gonna go to my comments. We've already done it, really. Have I missed Carrot in a Box? I'm gonna be honest with you, you have. We haven't done Carrot in a Box for ages. Friend of mine in a band, he was in a band, he's a band called Grim Reaper. He was in Manchester University, and he was going out with a girl who was training to be a doctor. Where are they now? Brexit. But yeah, no, trained to be a doctor, and they were doing an operation, and they removed a carrot from a man's anus. His posterior, his bottom, his butthole, right, yeah? They removed a carrot from a man's bottom. And the guy said, any questions? And this one girl said, surely the carrot would have been digested in the stomach first. Anyway, innocence. Yeah, no, Stevie Kewin. Christmas hen nights is required. Me and Av were talking about it. It's too much effort. But I'll see what we can do in the new year. I'm gonna do a Steve Henn show in probably February or March, depending on how the situation unfolds, and then we'll be hopefully taking the hen nights back. But we just don't know. We just don't know, because like, who knows? Who knows? I do a podcast with Av every Monday night at 8 p.m. talking to our souls. It's a pun on our souls. Funny, isn't it? So, like, it's worth keeping abreast of that. I will try and get a Christmas or New Year hen nights in the box. Let's see if, I don't know if there's any need, not need, interest, but we'll see. Right, let's go. I told you about Sia's Christmas album. How about Gwen Stefani? Now, I know Steve likes Gwen. I'm not sure if he knows this album. But Gwen Stefani, I can't believe Gwen Stefani looks as good now as she did like 40 years ago. I don't think she's changed. But hey ho, here it is. Under the Christmas Lights, Gwen Stefani.
Christmas lights.
I was aware that one finishes quickly. I think the next one finishes quickly. We've only got two more songs to go in this. Steve Henn's alternative Christmas songs. Gwen Stefani. Excellent. That's all I can say. Gwen Stefani, that album's a good Christmas album as well. Hey. Are you ready for my personal favourite Christmas song of all time? Of all time. I think it's like all the bits in the song make it a great Christmas song. It's probably not the greatest Christmas song you're ever going to hear, but for me, it's got everything. Oh, man. Right. I'm going to remove that, and then I'm going to bring myself back. So, yes, sorry about that. We had a hiatus with Facebook. Facebook decided that Gwen Stefani was far too popular, and Warner Brothers have probably claimed that one as well. Well, I'll tell you what, Warner Brothers. That's me. Oh, I did ask actually what people's favourite Christmas songs were. Kira Swannell said Mistletoe, and I'm not sure if that's actually Cliff Richard's Mistletoe and Wine or the Bieber one. It's probably the Bieber one. I don't know if I know it, to be honest with you, so I can't judge whether it's like a classic Christmas song, a crap Christmas song, or just a Christmas song. But you are now about to hear, in my humble opinion, the best song that represents Christmas. I'm not saying it's the best Christmas song. I'm saying it's the best song that represents Christmas. Are you ready for it? It's by I'm going to check this now on the Google. Right, because I know he died, but I don't know if he died this year or if he died last year or he died in 2016. Fucking hell. What's happened to the last 5 years? I'll give it five. Yeah. So, he's a country and western singer. My mum went to a social club once and she said, "What act is on tonight?" And someone turned around and said, "It's some cunt from Preston." She said, "What?" She said, no, he sings country and western. So here we have Santa Claus and Popcorn. Steve Henn's encapsulated Christmas song of all time.
Santa Claus and popcorn, jingle bells and reindeer horns, Christmas trees and mistletoe, Jesus loves me, this I know. Carolers singing silent night, Crosby dreams a Christmas white. We celebrate 'cause a king was born, with Santa Claus and popcorn. Children dancing around the tree, sleigh bells ringing merrily, snowballs flying through the air. Happiness is everywhere. Carolers singing silent night. Crosby dreams a Christmas white. We celebrate 'cause a king was born, with Santa Claus and popcorn. Santa Claus and popcorn, jingle bells and reindeer horns, Christmas trees and mistletoe. Jesus loves me, this I know. Carolers singing silent night. Crosby dreams a Christmas white. We celebrate 'cause a king was born, with Santa Claus and popcorn. Santa Claus and popcorn, jingle bells and reindeer horns, Christmas trees and mistletoe. Jesus loves me, this I know. Carolers singing silent night.
I forgot that one finishes quickly as well. I was miles away. I was enjoying myself. I was singing along to Santa Claus and Popcorn. Seriously, if you've never heard that before, tell me that that is not the song that sums up Christmas. Santa Claus and Popcorn. I was what? I was 40 years of age when I heard that song. So that was like 10 years ago. 10 years ago I heard that song. Santa Claus and Popcorn. Honestly, hey, do you know what? I want you to have a lovely, 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 lovely Christmas. I know it's shit. I don't know what that is. Is that an oxymoron? No, no, he's running the country. No. I want you to have a lovely Christmas. You can have a lovely Christmas. You don't have to snog everyone. Just keep your distance, wash your hands, and take your tests. That's all you got to do. And if you haven't, if you've not even considered vaccination, be vaccinated. Please be vaccinated. Right. We're going to finish with a beautiful song. It's a traditional song, and it's from a very, very new album by Julia Stone, who is the sister of Angus Stone, and who collectively go under the name of Angus and Julia Stone, who are, in my opinion, my third favourite of all time bands at the moment. They are so, so good. Do check out Angus and Julia Stone. They are brilliant. Her new album has got loads of Christmas songs. This one at the moment is my personal favourite. I want you to have a lovely, lovely, lovely Christmas. And let's see us all in the new year. Take care. Merry Christmas, everyone. And let's finish with Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas by Julia Stone. Thank you. Merry Christmas, everybody. No, seriously, I love two Australian women, Julia Stone and Missy Higgins. And I don't love them. I do. I don't know. I've never met them. But like musically, I love them. And I'm sure I could grow to love them. But no, honestly, have a lovely, lovely Christmas, everybody. Take care now. Bye bye.